Hi, I'm Nan Simonsen. I was looking for a bread that was gluten-free that I could offer as a addition to the many, many soup recipes that I share, because there's nothing like a piece of crusty whole grain bread with a delicious hearty soup. It is December 30th here in Southern California, and it's been raining for a couple of days, and it's in the 40s and low 50s, and for us that's really cold. And I found that I had saved a recipe from 3 years ago that Jill Dalton of the Whole Food Plant-Based Cooking Show had called the mother of all gluten-free breads. And I thought, okay, Jill, I'm going to make this again, because I made it then, and I'm going to make it again for you, because when I say get a crusty bread, which I did on one of my recipes, I thought, yeah, everyone but me, because I won't eat most gluten-free breads. Flip the package over, look at the ingredients. It's tapioca starch, corn starch, rice starch, potato starch. In other words, they're not a whole food plant-based alternative to a good whole grain bread like Ezekiel. They are simply a bunch of starches that, with enough chemicals, they can make rise and be fluffy and acceptable and unhealthy, actually. So this is a healthy alternative. Thank you, Jill. I'm going to talk about what goes in it, but I'm going to start with what I call the grains that aren't grains. They are actually superfoods that are seeds. And as a base, even though we're going to be using oats, whole or rolled oats, we're going to be adding to this recipe chia seed. Now, chia seed, if you've ever made chia pudding, is marvelous, because when there's moisture added to it, it becomes somewhat viscous and it can give you some body in a pudding, in a smoothie. Gosh forbid you spill it on a slightly damp sink and don't rinse it off. You've got this stuff stuck all over the sink. You can tell I'm talking from experience. And then this is quinoa. That's another one of its base grains that are really a seed. And quinoa, if you've ever purchased it, either on the package will say, be sure to rinse this. And even if it doesn't, unless it says pre-rinsed, always rinse it. There's something called saponin or saponin that is that's on the outside of the grain that can be rather caustic to our digestive system, and you want to get rid of it. So you grab a strainer, you put your quinoa in it, run it under water for a bit, shake it around, get rid of it that way. And there are some brands that are pre-rinsed. And this is a super grain, lots and lots of protein, and actually it's a complete protein, like soy is a complete protein, although all of our grains and seeds have all the proteins we need, but not necessarily all, what is it, 8 or 9 of the ones that combine or that make up a complete protein. But when we eat several different foods and the proteins are varying in strength in the different foods, they all combine to give us complete proteins. That's how, at almost 71, give me a few days and I'll be 71, and being whole food plant-based for going on 4 years now, I'm healthier than ever on a whole food plant-based diet with plant protein. We're going to get all the protein we need by getting it from plants. And then this is buckwheat. Ooh, I love buckwheat. Buckwheat is a seed. It's kind of like pyramid-shaped little grains. And buckwheat, I've shown you the quinoa package. I got this one from Trader Joe's, but you can get quinoa in white or red or brown. This is a mixed combination. I always get my grains and seeds organic when I can. I don't want all the additional spraying that goes on with conventionally grown produce. And this is organic buckwheat. And this is from Bob's Red Mill, gluten-free, meaning it, if something that is normally gluten-free, like oats, says gluten-free, it means that they didn't process it in a plant that they also process wheat in. If it doesn't say gluten-free, there's a chance that it was processed with other gluten-containing grains. That's why I go for gluten-free whole grains, or especially oats. And buckwheat has no gluten. Never did, never will. It's not a glutinous seed. And yet, this says gluten-free to make 2 points. One is that buckwheat has no gluten, even though it sounds like a wheat product. It's not at all. It's a seed, not a grain. And then, in addition to that, they also don't mill it with other wheat grains. Okay, so that was my Breville oven. I've got a couple of my favorite side foods. And by side foods, I mean when I'm hungry, I take a chunk, smear a little nut butter on it, have it with a cup of tea, and it's like eating a cookie. What am I talking about? The Japanese sweet potatoes that are white inside, super sweet, or the Frida's purple Stokes sweet potato that's deep purple inside and has more of those anthocyanins that we eat blueberries for than blueberries do. Far more. It's a very healthy food. Okay, so I'm baking those. I'm going to stick this bread in with that because it cooks at 350 for an hour, and I'll get to that in a minute. So what happened is, you know what it's doing? It's telling me to turn it around, rotate it in the oven, and I can make it stop by fooling it by opening the door and closing it, and then it thinks I've rotated it. So the recipe calls for soaking the quinoa, rinsed quinoa, and the buckwheat overnight. Well, I wanted this tonight. I wanted to cook it this afternoon and have it with soup later on. I didn't have all day, so I soaked it for 4 hours. I'm going to indicate on the recipe if that worked. I've made this before, and one of the things when I read the post again with this recipe on it, and people were commenting, some people commented that it was rather moist inside, which some people liked, some people didn't like as much. Maybe it needed to cook longer. But one person said she squeezed these soaked seeds in cheesecloth before she put it in the blender and blended it. Well, I didn't have cheesecloth, but I rinsed them well. I shook them well over the sink and kind of pounded them as it kind of flips around in there. But then I also took this strainer, and I want to recommend, if you don't have strainers, this set was maybe $14, $15 from Amazon, and it's three sizes. This size, which is a Cuisinart brand set, but any set will do. Fine enough screen so that you can rinse your, and even in the large one, so you can rinse quinoa. But we rinse our berries for our oatmeal in this in the morning. When I do quinoa or any rices or any grains, I always rinse them, and the screen is small enough so that things don't fall through. So when I tried to press out some water initially, after I was soaking, I pushed with my hand and I ended up with the grains all over. And how do I get them off? Rinse it off again into that and then have to start the process? So instead, I did the best I could and then washed my hands off. But then I pressed with this all over, and it helped me get a little bit more of the, I don't know if you could see that, the soaking liquid, which I wanted to do. So I'm going to put into my Cuisinart the half a cup each of soap, and I soak them together, quinoa and buckwheat. If it works to soak them 4 hours, I'll let you know. Otherwise, we'll leave it as soaking overnight, and I'll pay the price with having an extra crunchy bread. But I'm also going to add to that a cup and a half of, again, organic and gluten-free rolled oats. I'm also adding to that chia seed, and I showed you what chia looked like, and psyllium husks. If it was psyllium flour, I'd use less, but it's psyllium husks it asked for. I went to the place called Clark's. It's one of our health food stores. You can order it online, and I got psyllium husks. If you travel, you may want to carry a little jar of psyllium husks, stir it into water, because it helps you with digestion and constipation, which quite often happens to people when they travel. So I have some psyllium husk, I have some quinoa, I have a teaspoon of baking powder, a half a teaspoon of baking soda that I already put in here, so I'm just going to throw it in. If you don't use salt, don't add salt. But the recipe calls for a teaspoon of salt. I'm going to go ahead and use it. I'm not sensitive to it, and I'm fine having some salt. It also calls for a quarter of a cup of unsweetened applesauce. And this applesauce will add just a touch of sweetness to it. If you want a sweeter bread, you could add a little bit of date paste to it, but we don't want to change the proportions of liquid to dry very much. And then a cup and a half of filtered water. I don't want to mix it too much in the food processor. I could do a blender, but Jill Dalton recommends doing it in a processor. She says you'll get a better result. And of course we want the best result we can get. So I'll lock this in and okay, I don't want to make it too pasty. So I'm going to say that's enough. I didn't have a silicone pan. I have silicone muffin pans. I love them. You put the dough in, and when it comes out of the oven, I can simply push from the bottom and the muffin comes out rather cleanly. I didn't have a muffin pan, but I have, there are several sizes. This is an 8-inch. Of bread pans, and I have a larger, the 9-inch bread pan, 9 by 5. I wanted the smaller one because I want it to be higher. I don't want a really flat loaf. And this is just parchment paper, and parchment paper makes a nice lining. I took a tiny bit, a fingerful, not even a fingerful, of coconut oil. Why I even have that, I've had it for years and have not eaten it in anything, but I've used it for skin type things. So it's still in the cupboard, and I put a little bit on the sides. I don't know that it really matters, but it, or if this would have been enough. And then this is what it looks like. Let's see if I can do this and show you as I pour it out. You can see that it's thick, very, very whole grain. Let's get the S blade out of there. Goodbye. Oh, okay. Got a bit of a splat on the floor. Okay. Yeah, this is going to be nice and high. So there was baking soda, baking powder. But because there's not a lot, and there's a little acid from the applesauce, which helps activate them, but because there's not a lot of moisture, I don't think we're going to get much height here. We might get the smallest amount of rise from it. But this is going to be very grainy. That's the way I like my breads, sort of like an Ezekiel. But Ezekiel is a... they call it a biblical bread because it's made out of grains from the Bible, including wheat, whole wheat, that is sprouted. And a sprouted grain is a grain that has even more nutrition. And these seeds that I've just gone over, the buckwheat, highly nutritious, with proteins that do things that other grain proteins don't do for us. Quinoa, same thing. Chia seed, same thing. High proteins, high fiber. Good, healthy, and you notice there is no sugar and there's no oil in this bread. And I think that's going to be it. I'm going to put it in for an hour. I'm going to take it out, and I'll add a photo of what it looks like out. But I'll bring you back on when I'm going to cut it and show you what it looked like. Okay. I think that's it. Look what I have. Yum, yum, yum. It actually smells like rich grains. Can't wait. All right, I'll be back with you. Okay, I'm back. So the loaf took an hour. If it was spongy when I took it out, I would have, or if I could feel that it wasn't, you can hear this, solid and cooked through, I would have put it back in maybe another 10 or 15 minutes. But look at this beauty. Look at that. And I'm going to slice it. What happened is when I took it out of the pan, I had the parchment paper up the sides. I cut along the sides because it was stuck to the sides, even with that little bit of oil, and it came right out. I let it cool. I have a bread knife, and I'm going to, shoot, this is a right-handed bread knife. That's funny. I don't know how to do things right-handed, but I'm gonna learn. All right, give it a nice, you can hear it. Oh, nice, nice, nice. Look at this. It is still a little warm. One of my favorite spreads is a chutney. This is a mango chutney I get from Trader Joe's. Mmm. Oh, wow. This is really good. I could have put a nut butter. I could have put a vegan cream cheese. It's oil-free, all grains and seeds, and a beautiful bread. Thank you, Jill Dalton. Make it with your soup. I'm going to have some soup tonight. That's going to go along with it. Enjoy. Thank you for joining me. Have a great day. I was going to say day because it's evening here, but I know I'm going to. Bye-bye.